Hello everyone, how are you today? I am doing good and well. I was originally going to have a look around where normally the Naughty Tree area is, but there's a problem with that. Normally, if you go down there, if you can see where that bridge is, that's where before I've walked down there, and the Naughty Tree would normally be around over there. But for some reason now, they completely changed it up, they have. I saw a sign that's about horse owners, but because it's got a chain around it, I don't know if they completely made this land private, or I don't know, because I know I've been around in that area before, because there's a path sign over there, as you can see that yellow rectangular shape thing next to that bridge. So as I'm guessing, I think they made that land completely private now, unfortunately. I wonder if the Naughty Tree has put this chain there, I wonder. What do you think? I don't know. So it looks like the days of seeing the Naughty Tree is pretty much over for me, really. But there's no need to worry. We can go somewhere else we can and have a look around. And you're probably thinking, what are you doing walking around in the fields?
Haven't you got better things to do?
Pay your bills,
do your laundry,
go to school.
Well, obviously I don't pay bills because it's a different thing with my bungalow. I don't go to school anymore and I've done my laundry. What is it with this jealousy? Are you still jealous about my bungalow, are you?
Is it you, doom and gloom and grey and rain? What about you, Ben Bryan? I'm watching you.
Anyway. Let's go this way. Come on. I don't think going down there today would be a bit of a good idea because it looks like it's a bit muddy around there. Like I was trying to go up to the gate earlier, the path towards where the Naughty Tree area is. You're probably thinking why I am looking around in these fields.
That's because you remember when I felt like I didn't really have a purpose a little while ago, and I felt a bit lost within myself. I'm just looking out for rotten reality, just in case he's trying to pull up another sleeve in my well-being and my contemplative mind. So it's like a new mystery, really. Like I used to try to find the creepy voice, the magic windmill mystery. Now I got a brand new mystery. The unknown tricks of rotten reality. Nah, I don't think rotten reality will be hanging around in these fields all day long, I don't think. Thank you. Maybe Ross in reality has finally given me a break or something after what he did to me. I am still contemplating about it because it's a similar mystery to the creepy boys and the magic windmill mystery from a long time ago.
Come on.
I do have to say, rotten reality was really bothering me ages ago, I can tell you. I felt really lost within myself, I did. But since some people convinced me to, you know, not to give up in life, I just take one day at a time, really, and just... Well, I know life after college is not always simple for me, but it's just a matter of time and see how the next many years goes on for me, really. I'm going to have a drink of water, and then I'll probably possibly head back to my bungalow after this. I wonder how the people I know in my personal life are doing nowadays, I wonder. I don't know. I wonder how Paul's colleagues are doing his new place. I've heard about that Paul Perkinson has moved to a new apartment for his job and for his colleagues to live in and work. Well, it's 7 minutes past four now. While I have a drink and a sit down and watch the world go by, what about you lot? See what Paul's colleagues are up to and see what advertisement you might see today on this episode. I'll see you later.
Sunroom, I wonder what fun things that can be in that room, Rob Robot.
I have absolutely no idea, Andy Alien. This is only our brand new home. We just moved in very recently. All of these rooms are curiously interesting and mysterious.
Interview room? That must be when Paul Perkinson does interviews with each colleague of their status and scores. That's including me and you know.
I hope I do my best for Paul Perkinson as Jonathan Jack betrayed us ages ago for Crash and Canton. That in the immediate he recounts he'll be better than me and you, Andy. We were homeless at Queen's Park back at Loughborough and I am so glad of not only finding a new home for us, but also never to having to see or hear from Jonathan Jack ever again as long as I live in my robotic years.
Me too. I love my own clothing as it's better for me than just walking around the public clothesless.
Oi you two, where are you are going to be late for Paul's annonsaman? Come on.
Okay, Alessandro Pippa check out. Give us a chance as we are only getting to the used of our new home.
Yeah, Alessandro, leave my best friend alone. You are reminding me of Jonathan Jack.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen. I have an important announcement to make with you all.
Have you found a new co-head worker for your company?
Has Oliver Lockwell finally been found?
Have you got a girlfriend of your own, Paul?
No, and no Alan, Olivia, and Beth. I have good news based on a colleague who hasn't been with us for ages. We have a returning colleague who is with us right now.
Is it Daniel Dickinson? I can finally ask questions to him about my long-lost brother.
Is it Matilda Perkinson? I am so happy to see her again. I have been missing her so badly.
It's not Prashant Kanchan, isn't it? Oh no. He tried to murder me before you sacked him.
It's not Daniel, or my older sister, I'm afraid, Chia-Hao Chiknug, or definitely Prashant Kanchan Beth. It's Chia-Ling Heliponter.
Surprise, Olivia Lockwell, Hugh Jackson, Alan Burberton, and Beth Bumblehaw. And hello to a few new faces I have never seen here before with you, Paul.
Hi, Chia-Ling. It's been way too long since we've seen each other last time. I thought you died of COVID from June of 2021.
Well, long time no see, Chia-Ling. It's been well over a year since you were with us. Yes, there are lots of new faces here since before you left for China last year.
Well, hello to my killing darling. It's nice to see that you're alive and fine, as we all thought you were dead from the coronavirus that your doctor told Paul and Matilda Perkinson about.
So if you are here right now, Chia-Ling, how come you didn't die from COVID? Did the doctor lie to Paul and Matilda about your death?
The truth is, Olivia, Hugh, Alan and Bess. I never had COVID in the first place, and I was kidnapped by some Chris Tucker bloke like guy someone from Russia or possibly, and made me stuck in China for 6 months straight. I had to use my kung fu moves and karate knowledge to fight my way back to the UK during the Christmas holidays of last year. It took me 90 days to reach the country of England, which is here. I then have to spend 50 days walking back to this community on foot with a small amount of money I had, because I never converted my money back to pounds due to the Chris Tucker bloke alive stolen my purse.
And what about your mother, Chia-Ling? Has she died from COVID?
Unfortunately, Alan Burberton, yes. She died from the coronavirus 4 days after I arrived in China. Since her death, I only have my father and younger brother, who is currently in my hometown trying to fight throughout life without my mother. My father has nowhere been as nice, caring or amazing as my mother, and he have been doing drugs and been on a Chinese version of Jeremy Kyle due to cheating on my mother for a rich lady back in 2007. My younger brother Chen Heliponter, however, is an amazing man who has been to university for 10 years and currently works somewhere in London with a bank cooperation. I might invite Chen someday to introduce him to you all here at Post Advertisement Apartment.
Wow. You have been through a lot of personal experiences, Chia-Ling. It's nice to know more about yourself with your mother, your drug addict Jeremy Kyle bloke father, your formative younger brother Chan, your story of late 2021 to early 2022, and the truth of your absence from us.
I feel so sorry for you that you lost your mother from COVID and having your father let you and Chan down. That story is amazing and beautiful.
My name is Kate Napucopter Chia-Ling. I have been helping your business out by taking over as manager while you were away in China. I would like to be your assistant and carry on working at your helicopter rides, especially by the fact I am a helicopter pilot myself.
Well, hello there, Kate Napucopter. I am honored and proud of you for continuing my business while I wasn't available to do the job myself. Please work for me as my honor and say hello to your new head manager.
What a great honor to have Chia-Ling Heliponter back with us again and be moving into Paul's advertisement apartment.
It surely is, Olivia.
Wow, what an amazing story. Her personal background is just as better as mine.
Completely agreed with you there, Kia Ochiknag.